The last 2 weeks saw an increase in COVID infections in the Philippines across all age groups, with the biggest hike seen among those ages 30 to 39 years old. Data also show a more than 44% increase in new COVID infections among individuals 20 to 29 and 40 to 49 years old, or the working age group, compared to the July 13 to 25 data. In Makati City, current COVID vaccine supply for essential workers, or the A4 priority group, is just enough for the week.
Madami tayong supply for A1, A2, and A3. Yung sa A4, medyo malapit na rin maubos in a few days. Pero ang sabi naman sa amin ni National is may mga parating pang additional na vaccines.
In the case of Mandaluyong City, not all those who belong to the 20 to 49 age group are part of the A4 priority group, which is why the local chief executive is making this appeal.
Pag tinanong mo sila, ma'am, kasi wala kami pa sa priority list. Which is true. And some of them, ito yung medyo wala pang trabaho. Pwede na sana buksan na natin sa general population. Para sa ganoon, sila na yun na tinatamaan eh.
Children aged 9 years old and below posted the second biggest increase in new COVID infections the past 2 weeks, while the 10 to 19-year-old group recorded a 43% hike in COVID cases for the same period. Despite this, the Department of Health does not recommend opening the COVID vaccination to minors just yet. Health Secretary Francisco Duque explains the Philippine supply of Pfizer jabs, the country's only COVID-19 vaccine with emergency use authorization for children 12 to 17 years old, is not enough to start the inoculation of minors. He adds health experts and officials still need more time to study the effects of COVID-19 vaccines on children. But Duque says there is a way to protect minors from getting COVID infection.
Ito po yung tinatawag na cocoon concept. Na kapag halimbawa sa isang bahay, lima kayo, babakunahan yung apat, yung bata doon, kahit na hindi bakunado, protektado na rin po siya.
The private sector is also eyeing to procure Pfizer's COVID jabs for children of employees.
The reason why we're looking at this is because Delta is hitting the children now, no? And that's all over the world. We're asking Secretary Galvez if we can also support and bring in some Pfizer, no? So hopefully we're still trying to see how far that can go. Similar to what we've done with AstraZeneca, what we've done with Moderna.
Of the target 70 million Filipinos, only 11.6 million have been fully vaccinated so far, while over 13.3 million are partially inoculated. In Metro Manila, daily COVID vaccination increased to a record of over 207,000 doses. But it is still a long way from the target of 250,000.
This is really dependent on the availability of the vaccines. Mas maraming vaccines available, mas maraming maijajab yung ating mga vaccination teams from the LGUs.
The DOH-NCR urges local governments to open COVID vaccination sites on standby and coordinate with private partners to ramp up inoculation while the region is on lockdown. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.